Gangotri online classes. In the last class, we were discussing in molecular basis of inheritance. So the topic was about genetic code and mutation. So how this sudden change which occurs on nucleotide sequences causes the change of the codons as a result of changing of amino acids, thereby changes the particular protein. So mutation, nucleotide sequence again sudden change aagutte. ಅದರಿಂದ ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಆರ್ ಕೋಡಾನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಕೈತಿ, ಆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ಕೋಡಾನ್ದಿಂದ ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ, ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್, ಸಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಎನಿಮಿಯಾ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್, ಫ್ರೇಮ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್, ಎಡಿಷನ್ ಡಿಲಿಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟೇಷನ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್. ಸೊ ಟುಡೇ we will discuss about the translation. So what happens in a translation? It is a process of polymerization of amino acids from nucleotide sequence present in mRNA. Okay, so simply there is a synthesis of amino acid chain. Okay, this amino acid chain is synthesized based on what type of codons are present here. So mRNA information is written as the polypeptides or sequence of amino acids translate. Okay, so this translation process is take place in cytoplasm. Electrically cytoplasm, both in prokaryotes as well as in eukaryotes. Prokaryotes ಮತ್ತು eukaryotes ಎರಡು ಒಳಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತ್ರಿ, translation cytoplasm ಒಳಗ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ. So translation is the final process of central dogma. After the formation of linear chain of amino acids, linear chain of amino acid, that particular linear chain of amino acid is considered as primary structure is formed during translation. In the first year biomolecule chapter daga you study madiri that protein has different structures, primary structure, secondary, tertiary, like that. This linear chain of amino acid is considered as primary structure. Then from the cytoplasm it is moves to the Golgi. ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ನಿಂದ ಗೋಲ್ಗಿ ಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಇದು ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಟರ್ಷರಿ ಲೆವೆಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ a particular cell need for translation. Translation agabekandra particular cell or gene requirements are irbeku. Let's see. The first you require obviously mRNA. Okay, the messenger RNA that brings the information from a nucleus. So nucleus ille nenakke information tagonda barthe. So this mRNA is a single stranded structure which contains seven regions. Which contains seven regions. At 5' end, there is a presence of cap region. Yes, we're talking seven regions. Seven regions. Adhara first region cap 5' end is there. Ali endi methyl guanosine triphosphate aragathate in case of eukaryotic mRNA. Okay, then next, from this here to here at this region, this is considered as non coding region, are also called as untranslated regions. Untranslated regions, UTR1. Okay, the first is gap region and second is UTR1 region. Then next, it consists of initiator codon, okay, AUG. Then from here up to here, it is a coding region. The next is terminator codon. And next, from here to here, it is untranslated region 2. And the last one is poly A tail. So these are the 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 regions. 7 regions of a mRNA. Okay, so you know about the cap. There is a addition of methyl guanosine triphosphate. Okay, non-coding regions. So these are the regions. Non-coding regions are untranslated regions. These are the regions. Actually, these are the sequences. Which are present before initiator codon and after terminator codon. Okay, so initiator codon AUG. So codon's property show you ODRI. Codons are initiated. Okay, wherever there is a presence of AUG, amino acid sequences are in the startup. Adikintu munche yavadi sequence illi avinu tari untranslated regions are they do not read in translation. Okay, so do not read in translation. No amino acids are there for such a kind of untranslated regions, because either they are present before the initiator codon or they are present after terminator codons. Terminator codons UAA, UAG, UGP. Okay, so these are the codons at which the protein synthesis or amino acid sequences or attachment of amino acid sequences stops. Okay, at this region everything is dissociated. So after that, whatever the sequences are present out reda agulla. Okay, then okay, this is about the mRNA. The next, is about RNA. So RNA is the largest among RNAs, and it is the structural component of ribosomes. So it is the largest among all the RNA, mRNA, RNA, tRNA, ati largest iti, and it is present 70 to 80% in the cytoplasm. Okay, and it is a structural component. It forms the ribosomes. Okay, so ribosomes have, ribosomes are the small units matto larger units with nenapittu. Ribosomes are considered as protein factories. You can know protein factories at the level. Okay, yakandra particular amino acid sequences, idraga particularly ida ribosomes are amino acid sequences, Okay, the next, so these are subunits, it could be 28S, it could be 5.8S, it could be 5S, it could be 40S, 60S, large subunits, 60S, 30S, whatever it may be. All these small units, they together forms, and in the cytoplasm raga ribosomes, they are present in free state. Okay, so when yavaga amino acid sequences or protein synthesis start madod agirbeki, large subunit attaches to small subunits. Large subunit small subunit with enakidre attach. Okay, so this is about RNA, and which forms a particular component called ribosomes. The next requirement is tRNA. Soon the discovery of genetic code, Francis Crick, he discovered that a particular amino acids have no such special ability that they can recognize their own codon sequences. So Francis Crick, he discovered amino acid olaga anta yavade tarada ondu special mechanism or ability iralla, that amino acid tamade adanta codon ka recognize maadu. So there should be a molecule alli ondu nadu ondu molecule irabeku compulsory, that can read the sequences which are present in mRNA. One side mRNA olli iruvanta codon sequences odbeku, on other side on other side it should bring, it should bring particular amino acids. So second, a sequences a codon yav amino acid represent aagirthi ade amino acid da tRNA maadbeku thogonda barbe. Okay, so earlier this tRNA has a different name. It is considered as a soluble RNA. Idike entri hesara soluble RNA or sRNA anta hesaru. As this Francis Crick has discovered one more function of this sRNA, that function is a adapter, being a adapter molecule. A function enittandra adapter molecule gate work maarutte. So a adapter molecule, translator a codons ga particular amino acids ga represent maadodu, translate maadodu tRNA taagitre hesaridalla bande. Okay, so remember tRNA totally have 5 arms. Just antare 5 arms irutha. So there are two particular models are there of tRNA particular RNA models adavre. One two dimension model aitri. Idukku now clover leaf model athyo. Second three dimensional model aitri. Idukku now L shaped model. So two dimensional model as well as a three dimensional model. So this two dimensional model is proposed by R. Hawley, and three dimensional model is proposed by Clue, a name of the scientist. Okay, so you can observe, so like that. Okay, so this is the globe L shape model. So it is not a double stranded actually, don't confuse with this because RNA is a single stranded. So tRNA also is a single stranded. Okay, so this is a 3' end, this is a 5' end. Okay, so here amino acid binding site. This is T loop, this is DHU loop, and this is very important anticodon loop. In two dimensional also you can see here like that structure. Okay, this is amino acid binding site. This is 3', this is 5', this is T loop, this is DHU loop, and this is anticodon. So what happens in anticodon loop? Say for example this is mRNA, particularly mRNA category. You can take any one of the particular sequences like UAC. In the particular mRNA codon itandra, in the particular anticodon AUG. Okay, here AUG. So this UAC and here tryptophan amino acids are added. So in akate particular tryptophan in akate amino acids in akate particular add akate. Okay, if it is AGU here, here should be UCA and here serine amino acid is added. So whatever the codons are present in mRNA, the tRNA has particular anticodons. So these anticodons brings the particular or respective amino acid of these codons. So this type of questions they will ask in a CET. They will give a particular codon or anticodons. These are codons, mRNA wise codons, and this is the anticodons, and they will ask about a particular amino acid. If in a textbook it is mentioned that particular amino acid serine, tryptophan, whatever it may be, and they have given their anticodons as well as codons, so those questions can be asked in the exams. Okay, next. So whatever the anticodon region or anticodons are present, respective amino acids are bind at the amino acid binding site. So amino acid binding site by in a case amino acids attach across. This is very important. And at 3-OH end, the sequences are ACC or CAA, because 5-2-3-. Yes or no? 5-2-3-. If you are reading the frame, CACCA. 3-OH, CCA. 5- region, phosphate dienitrate, guanosine. The first nitrogen base is a guanosine, and the 3- and the last nitrogen base is a adenine. Remember this, okay? Particular. Next, T loop is held for attachment to ribosomes. So this particularly helps for attachment of ribosomes. And DHU loop is used to bind amino acids. Okay, so this contains a particular enzyme. Idra one particular enzyme irthati, that particular enzyme is called amino acyl synthetase enzyme. Amino acyl synthetase enzyme. So this enzyme is usually help in the binding of amino acids. Okay. The next requirement is that amino acids. So there are 20 amino acids are there, and each amino acid bring by each tRNA. So that means there are 20 tRNAs are there. And remember, some amino acids, they will come only once in a polypeptide. Repeat going. Some amino acids like methionine, initiator amino acid, first amino acid, it will never repeat, because E amino acid yav kuda represent aketi AUG, adu kuda repeat agangilla. So E amino acid thagon baru anta tRNA, initiator tRNA. So that initiator tRNA will not also repeat, and it will not bring any other sequences than a methionine bit mat bare yavude amino acid thagon barangilla. Methionine onda sarti bartendre ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ AUG ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕೋಡಾನು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಅಮೈನೋ mRNA ಒಳಗ ಒಂದೇ ಸರ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್, ಮೀಥಿಯೋನೈನ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಬರುವಂತ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎಂಗ ನಾವು ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟರ್ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 20 ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ 20 ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಯು ಏನಾಗ್ತಾವ್ರಿ ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ ಹೋಗ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೋಡಾನ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರಾಗ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟು ಕೋಡಾನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ. Okay, so this is about amino acids. One particular amino acid, not another particular amino acid, nodu yav bond irthe andra peptide bond irthe. So So this you have studied in a first year biomolecules topic. So this a peptide bond. It actually any form of it and the first amino acid the carboxylic group, next amino acid the amino group. ಇದರ ನಡು ಏನಾಕೈತಿ ಪೆಪ್ಟೈಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎಚ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎಚ್ ಟು ಓ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇದೇನ್ರಿ ಡಿಹೈಡ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇದು ಡಿಹೈಡ್ರೇಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ಸಿ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಎನ್ ಇದೇನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪೆಪ್ಟೈಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟು ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪೆಪ್ಟೈಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಎರಡು ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇರ್ತೈತಿ ಒಂದು ಪೆಪ್ಟೈಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ ಹತ್ತು ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರ ಒಂಬತ್ತು ಪೆಪ್ಟೈಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಓಕೆ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಒನ್ ಒನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ನೀವು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇವು ಕೂಡ ಏನದಾವ್ರಿ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅದಾವ್ರಿ ಎಂ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ದೆನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ ರೈಬೋಸೋಮ್ಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆಸಿಡ್ಸ್ So these all requirements are very much needed for a translation. Translation aagbekandra ee ella requirements are compulsory beke. Then and only then with the help of all these requirements ee ella requirements la help denda one particular amino acid sequences or chain in aagidre form aagbe. So next translation olaga moor steps bartavre one initiation elongation ಮತ್ತು ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಷನ್ದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ಎಲಾಂಗೇಷನ್ದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಟರ್ಮಿನೇಷನ್ದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ದಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು